So we have three main goals for this video. The first being take this receiver, which has no clue what it's in, and at least program it to where the plane will fly. It's a clean setup, no gyro, no AS3X, no safe, just correct control surface movement, correct gear operation, correct flaps, throttle, etc. The second goal is setting up AS3X, basically the gains, my flight mode switch, etc. The third being, I'm gonna show you how to set up safe select on this. Hey there everyone, welcome back to Horizon Insider. In today's Tech Talk, I'm gonna show you how to do some Spektrum forward programming using any Gen 2 DSMX protocol transmitter. Now this includes the whole brand new NX family of transmitters. This includes the IX family of transmitters, the DXE, and any of the DX family. Now, keep in mind with some of those older style legacy transmitters, you will need to update the firmware. So if you just bought it off the shelf and you've been flying the same way ever since, you can't do forward programming without updating the firmware. So keep that in mind. Now, a couple caveats to consider. The main purpose of this video is to show you how I'm programming a Spektrum AR637 receiver to this FMS CJ-6. Now, the receiver itself is the same model you would get if you went to a local Horizon Hobby retailer or purchased one on horizonhobby.com. It's basically like, we call it like an off-the-shelf receiver. So there's really no built-in programming, there's no built-in AS3X, there's no built-in safe yet. The reason I bring that up is if you've bought a bind and fly basic plane from us with basically all of 2020, you probably have noticed that you have a Spektrum AR637 receiver, but those receivers themselves are programmed pretty specific to the plane. They already come built in with the, you know, the correct gyro settings, the correct safe settings. You can technically unlock and jailbreak those and do this procedure, but keep in mind, it's not quite the same process as I'm gonna show you now. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna flip the camera behind me. We're gonna get a good nice shot tight and close on this transmitter, and we're gonna walk through this process. Okay, so let's dive right in. This is a brand new, basically an empty model. All I've really done is bound the NX6 to the plane itself. Also note that whenever you're doing a binding or any sort of setup work, we always recommend removing the propeller from the plane itself for a safety, obviously. Go to system setup. My model type is already airplane. I don't need to worry about the name right now. Aircraft type, this particular model is a one aileron, one flap, because of how I have the ailerons Y-harnessed and it has one flap servo. We don't need to worry about this. Flight mode, I tend to always put on my B switch up here. You may not actually need this setup, but for what I'm gonna do later on in the video, you do. So if you don't plan on using AS3X or safe, you don't need this, but for the sake of the video, I'm gonna do that at this point. And I can actually go back. Channel assign, oddly enough for this plane, I don't have to do anything because this is literally how I have everything plugged in. My ailerons are Y-harnessed into channel 2. My rudder and my actual nose wheel are plugged into channel 4. My gear retract servos are all Y-harnessed in channel 5, and then my flap servos in 6. And then I need to double check the switch assignments. Gear is A. Again, change this if you don't want to use A for your gear. And then AUX 2, which is what I just assigned that flight mode, we'll get to that later on. Notice how the NX6 has a number 7 here that comes into play later on. We don't have to worry about trim setup, and actually, to be frank, we don't have to worry about anything else here. So I'm gonna go ahead and get back. And let's go ahead and test our control surfaces. So the first thing I'm gonna test is my aileron. So when I push my stick to the left, the left aileron control surface should go upwards, which it does not. So we need to reverse the aileron, go to my servo setup. Again, you need to do all of this before you do any AS3X forward programming or safe forward programming. Reverse that, double check, left. Okay, we're good. Let's check our elevator. It looks like we are good. And then I'm gonna check my rudder. We are correct there. And now I know my gear actually needs to be reversed because my switch is actually down. My A switch, which is what I use for gear, is in the down or away from me position, and my gear is actually up. Typically, we fly in the opposite of that. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to reverse, and I'm gonna have to hold this plane up when I select this. So bear with me a second, guys. Okay, that is corrected. And then I'm not even gonna worry about my flaps right now because for the sake of the video, we don't actually have to show the programming of the flaps. Let's go ahead and set up a throttle cut just for safety purposes. I always put it on the back H switch, which you can't actually see on my current view. I'm gonna flip that and select it. The rest of this doesn't really pertain to anything else. So honestly, at this point, you could fly this plane. You wouldn't have obviously any AS3X stability, you wouldn't have any safe, but this is essentially what we would call a clean plane. This is a basic six channel receiver at this point right here. Again, double check your control surfaces, make sure everything is functioning properly. Again, I'd have to set up my flaps, but aside from that, everything's functional as a regular six channel plane right now. One more thing, when you go to the function list and scroll to forward programming, if you don't see this option, it could be two things. The first being you might need to update your radio itself, especially if you're running an older DX series radio, or you may actually need to power cycle the plane and rebind it to the transmitter. It's kind of odd, but just give those two things a try before you try to go any further with support or things of that nature. So I'm gonna go ahead and select forward programming. I'm gonna select gyro settings. And as you can see, this says first time setup. So I'm not cheating here for the video. This is literally the first time this receiver is gonna get set up. Let's select that. It's gonna remind us here that, you know, make sure the plane's actually set up correctly before going through this setup sequence. Hit next. Another reminder warning. So here, essentially what we're doing is training the plane, the orientation of the receiver. So it wants us to set the plane level, which I have. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit continue. Now, I'm gonna have to leave the screen here, stand up the plane on its nose so that it knows essentially what direction is down. So give me a second here, let me hold the plane up. Perfect, now this is a great time. You can always change this in the future. Double check that you have your receiver installed the same direction as what it has picked up here. So basically it looks like the Spektrum logo is near the tail of the plane where the antennas are. And this is where all my servo leads plug in, which is 100% correct. Also note that this could be flipped over as well, so make sure you check that. So I'm in orientation 5, I'm gonna hit continue. Gain channel select. So this is kind of tricky here, especially if you're only using a six channel receiver. You don't have to use a gain channel. What a gain channel really is it enables you to either turn on or off the gyro or do steps. So if you had like a knob, like say on a DX8 or even like an IX12, you could actually set the knob to where as you turn it, the gain would increase. For the sake of this video, I'm gonna skip this step because we don't really need to cover gain channel in this particular setup video. Receiver's just doing a power cycle here. Gyro settings, and now you see we have AS3X setting as a selection. So I'm gonna go ahead and scroll down to AS3X. I'm gonna go to gains. And to be honest, I would start with these as just a ballpark beginner setup. Every plane's gonna be a little bit different. Some planes are gonna need more than this, some are gonna need less. Also keep in mind that, you know, control surface size changes this as well. If you have really gigantic full span ailerons, you probably don't need a ton of gain because the control surfaces move so much when they do move. If you have tiny little control surface, you probably need more. So I would say start with this baseline, go to the field, and then tune through forward programming from there. So let's go back. Stick priority is essentially how far into the stick's travel you go before the AS3X fades away. Most of our planes, like bind and fly planes, are 160, so I'm not even gonna touch that either. The gain sensitivity itself it really directly relates back to what I was talking to with having another channel dedicated with like a knob to increase or decrease the gains from there. We don't need to worry about that there. Essentially, that just, you could turn up the sensitivity if you needed to. Okay, so let's go down to this first time safe setup. So it's wanting me to configure a flight mode channel. So remember how I mentioned that the NX6 had that extra seventh channel down at the bottom way back when we were talking about the channel assign? This is where that's key. The NX6 can actually operate seven channels, if you will. So I'm gonna go to flight mode channel. Let me cheat a little bit here. I know what switch I'm gonna be on. So you see AUX2 comes up, or you can select whatever switch you need to be.
This is now capturing that channel 7 aux 2 B switch that I made earlier. So remember when I said it wasn't 100% necessary unless you were going to use AS3X or safe? Well, here's where it's actually popping up for safe. Go ahead and hit continue. Select the desired flight mode switch to adjust settings for each flight mode, which I think we kind of already did when choosing B. Gains must be turned on and active in safe flight modes. Yes, we get that. Okay, here on this screen, all the receiver needs is basically to learn what flatten level is. We did already program the direction, but here's where you're really fine tuning what the plane is going to default back to when you flip safe on. So go to this and select level, model, and capture attitude. And as you see, we're almost perfect. We're at like -1 degree, -1 degree. We're just going to go with that. You could leave it on zero. Note that with tail draggers, this gets a little tricky. So if you have like a P47, a P51, a Cub, something like that, you need to be kind of careful here with the pitch. You may actually have to correct that at the field after the fact. Or obviously be doing this with the plane in a stand where it's not in its kind of kicked up tail dragger stance. Let's click next. And this is going to kind of just run through the angle limits. I like leaving this where it is because this is just a good baseline to go from. You can increase it, you can decrease it. This is just the pitch and bank and roll angle limits. Let's go to next. And it looks like we just need to hit apply, and the receiver's probably going to power cycle again. Yes, it is. Interestingly there, you may not have heard it, we just got two control surface wags from the plane, indicating that we now have safe select active. Of course, we can test this, but I'm going to switch back to my other screen to do that for you as well. Now, one thing that I might have missed when I went through that is the fact that if you get done programming this and your plane's still not reacting to AS3X, first off, make sure you bump the throttle above 25% to kick on AS3X. But second, note that you can go back into forward programming, go into the actual flight mode setup, and you can go through each flight mode. So I have three on this B switch, flight mode 1, 2, and 3, and actually decide if you want it to be AS3X on that channel, if you want it to be safe on that channel, or if you want the gyro disabled. So make sure, if again, you're struggling to get the plane to respond, go back into that flight mode setup and make sure you have activated AS3X and safe select. So what we need to do now is A, like I said previously, bump the throttle over 25%. So let's do that now. And now we should be able to test AS3X, which I do hear it working. Again, to test AS3X, we've done a lot of videos on this in the past, but essentially, pretend if the plane was flying in the wind, you know, if it was to kick up like this, you would want this left control surface to raise to counteract this motion. So just keep an eye on that. You can turn the gains way up to actually visually see this. Same thing with the elevator. You know, if all of a sudden the plane dove, you would want this elevator to kick up. So just kind of do that and make sure it's going the right direction. Safe. So let's go ahead and bump on safe. And this should be an exaggerated version of what I said before. So let's tip the plane to the right. And you see that control surface is starting to increase to try to level the plane back out. I've done another video where I actually did safe select binding on our older style AR636 receiver, where I showed that flipping a plane over is actually one of the best ways to check if you're in safe select mode or AS3X only mode, because the control surfaces right now are trying to flip the plane over because it's in safe select. Same thing with the elevator. It's going to try to flip the plane over as quickly as it can. If you are in AS3X only mode, notice there's no longer that desire to flip the plane, but you'll still hear a little bit of stabilization coming out of those servos. So that is AS3X only. See, there's no control surface change. And that is my safe select. So at this point, we now have a basic six-channel plane that has AS3X stability that we can adjust, tune up in the radio. We now have safe select that we can flip on if we need it. And then, of course, tune and adjust in the radio. I think all that's left to do is go fly this thing. Now again, reminder, please do a control surface check before you take off. Make sure everything is responding like it should. Make sure your AS3X is responding like it should. And again, make sure safe select is responding like it should. But aside from that, that has been programming, forward programming, using a Spektrum Gen 2 DSMX transmitter. specifically programming a Spektrum AR637. Again, this process will work for other forward programming enabled receivers. So if you're confused if you can do this with your radio or your receiver, let us know in the comments. And then again, reach out to our product support team. They can help you out with this stuff as well. So until next time, thanks for tuning in to this edition of Horizon Insider, and see you later.